Alright, hello everyone, and welcome to another Talking War Thunder episode. I have talked about this subject, I believe, once or twice in Talking War Thunder. Definitely once, I'm not sure about another time. But I've certainly talked about it before in normal War Thunder videos and such. And that's the case of team killing. You know, should you react, should you team kill, blah blah blah, all that kind of shit. And though I have my own opinions on the matter, a lot of people can say, you know, you shouldn't teammate, but until you're actually in the situation where you're pissed off, whether you're trying to defend yourself or trying to be an asshole, there's a lot... Well, I say trying to be an asshole, you shouldn't be an asshole, but if you're trying to defend yourself against an asshole, you get this different feeling in you that is wanting team kill. And, well, that's time for me to start ranting about my experience with the Russian server. There are a handful of servers in War Thunder. You've got the US server, the European server, the Russian server, and the Asian server. Now, I don't play on the Southeast Asian server because it's the only server that I don't get a steady ping on. It'll jump back and forth. I can play it. It's just at any moment the ping could jump straight up way too high for me. All the other servers are fine. Of course, US is the best. European is in the middle, and Russian is okay. But I have it selected on all three of those, except for the Asian one. So it'll randomly pick, and I often get multiple different types. But it seems that for some odd reason, the Russian server wants to backhand me and talk about how apparently these guys are the biggest assholes in War Thunder. Now let me just start off by saying assholes live absolutely everywhere, okay? This does not mean that there are not dickshits in the other servers and whatnot. In fact, they're everywhere. But and I have probably been team killed by plenty of people in those other servers. But the thing with this is this has happened in succession recently, and it's nonstop Russians, and not just some American playing on the Russian server. It's nonstop Russians on Russian servers being complete assholes. I have never had this much trouble with an asshole team, an asshole team killer or team damager or whatever you want to call it, in War Thunder in this much succession before. Okay, like I said, I've been shot down before, I've been destroyed by friendly tanks, and of course, you also have to remember there's always accidents, and none of these three things are accidents. One of the ones that I caused was an accident, but we'll get to that story in a minute. But there can be accidents. People can drop artillery. It'll be stupid if they drop it right on top of you. They shouldn't do that. But say they drop artillery and you drive straight into where the artillery is falling and you get killed, you blame it on them. Well, it's actually your fault. And it's an accident on everyone's part, but it's actually really your fault. You shouldn't have just driven straight into where artillery was falling, unless you had absolutely no choice. And if you had no choice, then don't complain about the fact that you were killed by friendly artillery. You know, and other things can happen, especially in aviation. A lot more, how do you put it, accidents can happen in aviation. Whether you accidentally crash into a teammate in a dogfight, or you accidentally shoot down a teammate, or something like that. And that's what the in-game voice commands are for. Because, especially on a Russian server, where probably little to no one is going to be speaking English, you can use the in-game chat commands, because it'll then relay that in their language. That which is why I usually don't, if I accidentally team kill or do some sort of damage or do something stupid, I don't type sorry into the chat like I do if I'm on a US server. I'll use the key commands to say sorry on the in-game voice thing. Well, the in-game, I don't know, voice commands or whatever you want to call it. But for some reason, the Russian server never ceases to actually let me play my War Thunder peacefully for some odd fucking reason. Okay, now I'm gonna go back to as recently as doing the Thunder League camouflages. I think it was when I was doing the Thunder League camouflages. I believe I was on a Russian server. It was on Advance to the Rhine. And I have three stories I'm going to talk about. I might have some other stories at the end, I'm not sure. But right now, three for sure stories that I'm going to talk about. Two of them are very similar. The first one that happened, I don't know, a couple weeks ago or whenever, when the Thunder League camouflages and when I started doing those, it was one among the first. I think it was when I was doing Thunder League camouflage. Either way, it was on a Russian server. It was on Advance to the Rhine. I'm in Ground Forces. I don't remember what vehicle I was in. I was in a... I think it was either a T-34-85 or... it might have been my Panther. No, it wouldn't have been my Panther. I think it was my... It was one of my T-34s, I believe. My D-5T is actually what I think it was. Yes, it was. Because that was during the match that I got my IS-2 camouflage, I think. I mentioned it in the Thunder League video. So if you know, go ahead and feel free to post down below. I mentioned it. I said, oh, and some asshole pushed me around the corner. And this is something I have never seen in War Thunder before. I've never seen anybody do it to another person, and I've never seen it ever done to me. Okay, now at the start of a match, people can be complete dicks, and they'll run you over, and they will just keep driving into you. And then you're both stuck. And then they'll just keep driving. They won't stop. They won't turn away. They'll just keep pushing into you. That kind of thing is really annoying, but it's not like this. This is where you're sitting around a corner and there's like six or seven enemy tanks around the corner, and here comes this asshole behind you. He's like, huh? And he pops up your ass and pushes you out into the enemies. This is some World of Tanks bullshit, and I have never had it done to me ever in all of my hours playing Ground Forces in War Thunder. I've never even seen it happen to other players. I mean, I pushed enemy tanks, you know, and I've seen other people push enemy tanks, that kind of thing, yeah, but not pushing friendly tanks out into enemy fire. Of course, I get killed in one shot. Then, this asshole is in a Sherman Firefly, okay, the premium one, so what I'd assume is that this asshole, because he didn't have he had barely any stats on his stat card, so what I'd assume is that this asshole is what people call wallet warriors, where he has little to no experience with the game, and he just buys himself a higher tier premium vehicle to grind out some shit, and he expects to be the most badass player in the world. And by badass player, that means let's drive into other actually experienced drivers and get them killed, putting your team down one tank, and also putting him down one tank, because after he pushed me around the corner and I was dead, he shot my husk. He didn't shoot at an enemy tank and hit my husk. He just shot my husk for some reason. It's like he wanted me dead. He shot my husk, destroyed it. I'm sorry, I was destroyed. He shot my husk, and then somebody came around and destroyed him. And I wasn't in a good mood, of course, because I was trying to get the Thunder League camouflages. So, of course, when I'm trying to do something, people are going to be assholes for some odd reason. Now, the next one that happened... this one's going to be a little bit more complicated and probably go into a little bit more detail. It's an arcade aviation match. I'm flying my Spitfire F Mark 9, I believe. It's one of, again, I'm working on trying to get the Thunder League camouflages. And I think I also brought this up in the Thunder League video when I unlocked it. It was one of the Spitfire Mark 9s, I think. And I was so freaking close to killing... Oh, no, wait. Yes, I was so... No. Fuck. I was so freaking close to killing bombers in that match, but of course, they all ended up in assists. And then I just decided, fuck it, I'm done going after bombers. So instead of staying way up high in the sky, I went straight down to fight the other fighters with our fighters. Now we have this Russian player, who is, of course, in a Russian plane. I'm in a British plane. Now, it's me behind an enemy, and in front of that enemy is that Russian player, and he's on my team. Now, that enemy plane is chasing my teammate, okay? So what am I trying to do? I'm trying to help his ass, right? And something very unlucky happens. I'm shooting at the enemy plane, and a stray bullet or stray cannon shell flies past the enemy plane and just so happens to hit the fuel tank of the friendly plane, catching him on fire. Complete and absolute accident. I wasn't trying to do it on purpose. It wasn't that I wasn't paying attention. I was just trying to kill the enemy plane, and it just so happens that a stray shell or bullet flew past and ended up hitting the friendly plane. I end up taking down the enemy plane, and of course, when you catch on fire, especially if it's a teammate, they burn out, they die, and you are credited with a team kill, or should I say, like, decredited with a team kill. And apparently this didn't make him happy. Now, I said sorry into the in-game voice commands, and I flew on as per normal. It was only a few seconds right after I said sorry, because I was too trying to focus on trying to put the voice command in, that I got shot down by an enemy plane. So I spawned back in, and here I am, flying forward in my next plane. I believe this, what I jumped into next or whatever, was the other Spitfire Mark 9, where you just have to get kills, I think. Oh no, yes, it was the one, I jumped into the other Spitfire where you have to finish in first place. And I was still, I was trying to have a go. I'm only like, I'm one death and one kill, you know, I'm not having a fantastic match. And that other guy had spawned in before me, and he is, I'd say, about 2-3 kilometers ahead of me by now. And of course, the moment I spawn in, suddenly, it's 2.50 kilometers, 2.1 kilometers, 1.5 kilometers, 0.3 kilometers, and by that chance, or by that time, I knew that this guy was trying to, it was coming to try and team kill me. You know, in ground forces, you can have a teammate look at you with their gun, but that doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to try and team kill you if they're pissed off at you. But this guy in aviation, you don't have a gun to turn and look at others with. If they're flying straight at you, you better move. Now, British plane, Spitfire, can't outmaneuver any Russian aircraft, apparently. I do try to avoid it. I don't retaliate. I try to avoid his shots, and he ends up getting on my ass and shoots me down. I die. I report him and basically call him an asshole in the chat, because I did apologize for the accident that had happened earlier. This guy went out of his way to hunt me down and kill me. And it gets worse, okay? Apparently, Russians are like bees, beehives. Once one stings you, they all try and sting you. And that's exactly what this match was like. So I'm up on 2 deaths and 1 kill. I'm not in a good mood because I was trying to get the camouflage, and I've just now been team killed after apologizing for accidentally killing the guy the first time. And I jump into another plane. I try to ignore it. Jump into another plane and start shooting at some planes. Okay. And of course, I'm on a tail of an enemy aircraft, and there's a teammate behind me, and another teammate behind him, okay? I'm shooting at this plane, I get an assist. That's perfectly fine. Somebody else kills it. So I flip around, and I start taking hits, and I'm ding, 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 and I'm like, what the fuck is this? So I turn really hard, look behind me, and there's 2 fucking other Russian players with Russian planes on my ass, and neither of them are the one guy that had killed me just a second ago, or the guy that I had killed, I guess I should say. These were 2 completely different players. They weren't in a squad, they weren't in the same squadron. They were 2 completely random players on my ass. They don't kill me, but they cause so much critical damage that I end up being unable to outmaneuver an enemy aircraft, and then the enemy aircraft shoots me down, which is, I would actually like to call, the fault of those fucking assholes in the Russian aircraft. And these were clearly Russians, because they were talking Russian in the goddamn chat, and they had Russian-ish names. Names that weren't English, I guess I should say. And so I'm really in a bad mood on 1 kill, 1 assist. And this isn't like one of the things where you, like, somebody says, oh, you stole my kill, so I'm going to shoot you down, because I got an assist on it. I didn't get any air kill for it. So I'm sitting here on 1 kill, an assist, and 3 deaths, and I'm not feeling too well about, or too good about myself, so I jump into one more aircraft, and for some reason, a completely different teammate decides, oh look, here's that juicy boomerang Mark II, the asshole that apparently has been killing everybody in the match, and he turns on me, and I can see him coming straight for me. He shoots at me, causes critical damage, overshoots. I just bail out and leave the match because I wasn't having any more of that. And I wasn't really retaliating. The only retaliation I had was me trying to stay out of the way of these assholes who were shooting at me. And this was on a fucking Russian server again. And the entire goddamn server seemed, hey, let's go after this asshole, apparently, because he's an asshole, apparently. Oh, God. And then the last one just happened right now. Like, the match I just played, I'm trying to do my daily challenges, okay? Now, I don't know what Gaijin is doing, but they seem to be... They can't get their fucking minds made up about when they want these specials to end. It was originally 6 o'clock is when the time will flip over for me. Then they switched it to 5 o'clock. And last night, I'm like, I have some of those daily challenges to finish, but I've got like 3.5 hours before it's done, because it's not. That's 3.5 hours before 5 o'clock. So I do something else for like an hour or so, come back, and I see, oh, it ends at 4:20. I have 37 minutes left to do 2 full challenges. To do 1 full challenge, actually. I'd finished one of them. Or 2 of them, I mean. To do 1 full challenge, and I couldn't find an easy one to do. Of course, it was the harder one. And it was for 80 freaking war bonds, and I missed it because they changed the times again with no news. It was supposed to always be 6 a.m., then they switched it to 5 a.m., and now it's apparently 4:20 a.m. The hell? What? That makes no fucking sense to me. So I missed out on 80 war bonds, and so today I'm trying to write as early as I can. I mean, it's 2:52 p.m., but I want to get these daily tasks done as soon as possible so that I don't have to worry about missing out on them again. Okay, I've completed 1, right? I'm on my second one, which is to get 18 kills with SPGs. I jumped into my M18s. This is going to be pretty easy. First match I get, a Russian server. You can see it coming, can't you? Something fucking shitty happens again. Okay, and this time, I'm so fed up with these goddamn Russians that I do retaliate in a way that you should not do, but I do. Now, in arcade, you cannot physically easily shoot a teammate, because when you aim at a teammate, a little blue X shows up, and you can't open fire with your gun, even your machine guns. Well, that I know of. Yeah, you can't even shoot them with your machine guns if you're looking directly at them. Now, you can trick the system and, like, move really fast and then quickly turn left, and just before your gun, you know, points at them, shoot, and you can actually basically kind of curve the shell and it'll hit the tank and can kill it. But that's not what happens in this match. It's very, very similar, and, it's very similar to the first match that I talked about, where somebody had pushed me around a corner. In fact, that's exactly what happens, but to a little more extent. Because in that first match, that asshole didn't even say anything, right? I completely forgot to mention, in the aviation match, that one guy that I had accidentally killed did say, he did speak English, but it was really shit English, and he had the little parentheses after every single thing he said. But he said, "You kill me," or something, with a parenthesis. And then he said, "Sorry," with 1 R, with a parenthesis, because apparently physically hunting me down and trying to shoot me down is something to apologize about, when I actually committed an accidental mistake that I did apologize about with the in-game voice commands, okay? Because I didn't know you even spoke English, or could at least speak a little English. You know, normally I would just plop "sorry" into the actual chat. But apparently people, but apparently people don't want to accept that. So here we are. I'm trying to do these tasks, okay? Of course, here I am trying to do something again, and the Russians want to completely fuck it up. Now, there are assholes like this guy everywhere, but for some reason, I'm only recently finding the Russian servers to be the only place that is treating me like complete trash, okay? Now, I have no idea what this word means. At least to my knowledge. But this guy, okay, kept using this word pitter. I have no idea, I'm probably not even pronouncing it right, no idea what it is, what it means, okay? It's spelled P-I-D-A-R or E-R, I think. Feel free to post that in the comments below. No idea what it means, I've never even heard of it before. Anywhere. So I don't know if this guy was just talking gibberish or what. So there's absolutely no word in the chat as the match starts. Okay, I'm in my M18 Black Cat. Okay, it's a vehicle with paper thin armor, and I just need to get 18 kills. And this vehicle's very deadly, very mobile. So I go and I cap a zone, and this asshole is in his Russian tanks. And yes, he does finish the match in first place, which is completely sad, but it's not hard to in a T-34-85 anyways. But here's the thing. I help cap the zone, and it's on the Poland map, and you know that square in the middle, kind of where like that church is. Now I'm trying to like you know, relay all the information to you guys. But you know how on Domination, to the north, you've got the A point, you know, the very north of the town. It's sometimes the C point, though. That's why I... The very north part of the town, you've always got that cap zone in Domination. Then you've got a cap zone in the middle and one way across the lake, okay? That's what this mode was. It was Domination. So I'm at the top cap zone, and I'm coming down through one of the roads, which is, it's very hard to explain unless you were looking at a picture or something, unless you understand. And you've got that cap zone in the middle, and I'm popping onto one of these roads, these side roads, so I can get shots into shit at the middle zone. Now there is like 4 or 5 enemy tanks over there that are completely not looking at me, okay? So this is great. I could pop out, shoot, maybe kill, do a lot of damage, pop back. Pop out, shoot, pop out. You get the idea. Do that kind of shit. So I park up, and this road is big enough, because NM18 isn't big at all. This road is big enough to fit two T-32s on. And you could easily scrunch something else between the T-32s. And T-32s are very big tanks. They're very wide, very broad. And I'm in an M18, and I'm sitting right at the corner. Pop out. I just look very quickly, I see a Panzer 38 and a Panzer 4. I shoot at the Panzer 38, it doesn't kill it, but it does a lot of damage, and suddenly the Panzer 4 starts turning his turret. So I quickly am like, shit, fuck this, back up, and I hit a rock. No wait, it's a friendly T-34-85, who instead of going around me, or backing up to let me actually get, you know, back, he decides, let's go full forward and push an M18 out into the open. To which I get shot by the Panzer IV, he knocks my engine out, knocks my gunner out, jams my turret, whatever the hell you want, and then somebody from down the main road decides, oh look, there's a juicy idiot M18 who's apparently wanting to stick out around the corner, and then he shoots me, and I die. Okay, of course, I report this asshole right away because I'm completely fed up with this bullshit. I'm fed up with these goddamn Russians on these mother... Okay, I'm... I already fucked up the joke anyways. I'm tired of these motherfucking Russians on this motherfucking game, okay? Because that's exactly what is going on, it seems, in my experience. It's the goddamn Russians over and over and over. And so now this is the second time in the span of a week or two that I have been killed by being pushed around a corner into enemy fire when out of the 3,500-something hours of War Thunder that I've played, I have never seen or had experienced myself ever before. Okay, and the thing reverse speed is usually never as good. Some vehicles, yes, but it is usually never as good as going forward. So it's different when you're trying to reverse into a tank going forward. You know, so you can't back up. I wasn't in a heavy tank, I'm in a fucking M18. There's not much I can do. Okay? And of course, I report the guy, and then suddenly I am being called a PIDR or PIDR. And he calls my entire squadron, and apparently everyone in it, PIDRs. So if you are in my ICATS squadron, which is not actually ICATS, it's just meant to be cats, the I is supposed to be silent. But if you're in my squadron, I just want you to know that you and I, and apparently everyone else, are PIDRs, or PIDRs, whatever that means. So I hope you're happy with your Christmas gift, your late Christmas gift, because that's what we all are now, apparently. And so, of course, and he's in a squad. He's got one other guy in his squad. That other guy, I don't think he ever did any shit. He didn't even say any words. I have no idea if they knew each other or anything. And this guy's name I'm not going to say his name because I would definitely love to say his name. People say you shouldn't name and shame. Fuck that. I want to put this guy's name out there. I want everyone to know exactly how much of an asshole he is. Fuck no naming and shaming. Screw that. In fact, you know what? If I had all three of these guys' names, I would put them in the description. I mean, I have this guy's name. I might even put it in the description anyways, okay? There's nothing wrong with getting news out there so that you can worry about these guys in an actual match. Because if you see one of these guys, then you better zip up your pants and stay way the hell away from these guys. Now, I know the name of this one. I can easily get it by looking at the replay. However... I don't know the other two, but his name isn't, at least as far as I'm concerned, it isn't anything English-ish. Now, he does, again, he speaks English, but it's that really broken, poor English. Again, And he's got those parentheses or whatever. I guess that's a Russian thing. I don't know. I'm not Russian. I just play on the Russian server, EU server, and US server to reduce queue times. But from now, if this happens again in the next week or two, if I'm team killed by another Russian on a Russian server, I'm completely turning the Russian server off and never, ever going back to it, because it pisses me off so much, especially when I'm trying to do a damn task. Now, I jump into an FW-190 A8. It's the one that has the two big rockets, okay? I'm now in a plane. I've jumped into another M18, you know, I'm doing my thing, trying to just go onto the match like it's nothing, okay? I've jumped into an attacker, I pressed the 8 key on the keyboard to jump into an attacker, and it gives me a fighter with two big rockets, alright? These are some pretty big-ass rockets. And I see, oh look, there's that T-34-85 that killed me, and he's right next to an enemy tank. Yes, I do try to go after the enemy tank, but it does end up killing my teammate instead. That was not completely on purpose. I did try to go after the enemy tank, okay? That was my main goal, right? But it ended up killing the friendly instead. Which, I'm going to be completely honest, I don't give a fuck. I'm actually kind of happy about that. And then he says report into the thing, because apparently I'm the asshole. I mean, yes, I did make a stupid decision, but I was having none of that shit, especially after all of the fucking times that I have tried to put up with this bullshit against these Russians. Okay, so I've now driven on, and I think I go on to get, like, one more kill before being killed by some enemy's artillery or something, and I had run out of tanks. And I would have had two of my tanks if it wasn't for this asshole. One of them was pushed out around the corner, and the other one... Actually, wait. Did I say two? I mean, one of my tanks, my one of my good tanks. What happened to my other tank? Ah, yes. I had I'd been killed in my Black Cat from the asshole in the T-34, and then I jumped into my M18 and drove on down the road, and I ended up getting hit in the ass by an M18 who finished me off, and then that's when I jumped into my other... I think I jumped into a backup M18, and then that's when I jumped into the plane, and that's when all the shit went down, and then I drove up to the front line. I got, like, one kill, and then got killed by artillery. I got four kills that match. One of them was a teammate, but I ain't sad about that. That's actually, I should put that at the top of my service record as the top kill, the shiny little reward, or award, because that's a fantastic achievement of mine. Not really, but still, you get the idea. And I know that it's only three things, and it's just your basic shit. You shouldn't, they always say, you know, if you're being killed by a teammate, you should not retaliate. You know, just let them do it. Fuck that. If I have the ability to retaliate, I'm going to fucking retaliate, okay? And especially in simulator battles. I am fed up with idiots who think they know what they're doing and drive simulator and start shooting at teammates in the same vehicle they're in, okay? I have no... absolutely nothing against that. I'll just give some examples. I've given these examples in other videos before, at least one or two of them. There was one match I was in a squad with another friend, and I'm in my M26E1, and he's in his T-34-100. Okay, we're in simulator battles, and there's a T-44 on our team, and he's between us. Now that my squad mate is T-34-100 is coming down the hill, coming towards me, and that T-44 is sitting between us, right? You know, I wouldn't say a stone's throw, but 100 meters or so, okay. And then that T-34-100, my squad mate, is like right next to that T-44, and of course the T-44 turns. And even though my squad mate's not even looking at the guy, he's not trying to shoot him, not trying to do anything, shoots my teammate. Excuse me, squad mate, right in the face. Thankfully it bounces, and I'm just waiting to see, is this guy stupid or did he make a mistake? But of course, even though he shot and it gave him no hit marker, no points, he decides, let's shoot at it again. To which I turned and shot him in the back of the turret and kicked that guy out of the match, destroyed his vehicle, because I don't want that kind of stupidity in my games when I'm trying to drive and win a match. You know, now you shouldn't kill other teammates because of the fact that it puts your team down one tank, right? And that does work most of the time. However, my squad mate in his T-34-100 was by far a way more valuable player than that asshole in the T-44. I shouldn't say asshole, that complete retard in the T-44. So I'd much rather love to destroy that asshole. Destroy that idiot, get him out of the match, and keep someone in there that's way more valuable. And no, it wasn't me just being like, oh yeah, I'm biased towards the friend. No, it was me completely being honest about the fact that I don't want these idiots in my simulator anymore. Another one was on Poland. I'm hidden around a goddamn corner, my Leopard 1, and here comes a friendly Leopard 1. Now this was back before I had my full Leopard upgrades. Well, I don't even have full Leopard upgrades yet, but this is before I had like Heat, FS, and stuff like that. And I think it was even before I had all the top tier German vehicles. And I'm sitting around a corner waiting for enemy tanks to come around so I could shoot them in the side. And I literally 4 feet to my right, a friendly Leopard 1 comes blazing around the corner, stops, looks at me, and shoots me. What? You're in the same damn tank as me from 4 feet away and you're too blind to realize I'm in a Leopard 2? You complete idiot. I'm looking at the goddamn enemies. I'm facing the enemies. But he still has the audacity to shoot me. And he catches me on fire, and that's all he does. I can't put the fire out, so I'm going to burn up. Of course, I turn to him and I kill him. I was fed up with it. And we were down 2 tanks that match because of it, you know. And you can argue that, yes, I shouldn't have done that because that put us down a tank. But with the fact that he had shot and killed me, even though he was in a Leopard as well, chances are he would have gone and done it 4 or 5 more times to the rest of our team. And I don't want him on the team anymore. This is why I don't understand. It's great if you want to play simulator, try it out, but do it if you know what you're doing. Don't play it until you do know what you're doing, okay? Because this is how stupidity is born, and this is really where you, if you don't know what you're doing, if you don't know what the tanks you're fighting are and what ones are on your team and what ones are not, don't know, you know, it's different if you're not really good at ranging guns at long range. That's fine. That you can learn, but you need to know who is on your team and what you are fighting and what they look like at what different kinds of distances so you can identify them. And you also need to know how to ID targets before shooting. If you come right out of arcade and you see something move, the most cases you're just going to shoot because you see something move. Turns out, oh, it was a teammate. There you go. You are now dubbed an asshole because you've shot a teammate, and you're a complete idiot because you don't know how to ID your targets. Don't play simulator until you know what you are doing, okay? It's awesome that you want to learn how to play, but don't do it until you know what you're doing, all right? And IDing your targets is not hard to do at all. You got a fucking machine gun. Most of the goddamn tanks in the game do, all right? That's because it makes it even worse when... It makes it even worse when I'm killed by friendly SPAA. In simulator battles, because they shoot you over and over and over again, and they don't get any points for it, and some reason they still think you're an enemy tank. I don't know. If you're not exactly sure what tank it is you're looking at, if you think it's an enemy, unless you absolutely know it's an enemy, shoot with your fucking machine guns, okay? And this is another thing that always pissed me off, is like when I get hit by, is like, the thing that always pisses me off is that some people will go to ID their targets, right? They will ID their targets using their machine gun, right? Okay, now don't shoot a machine gun at every tank, but if you're shooting a machine gun, say you're in the T-34 and you see another vehicle that you can't identify, your machine gun's not going to do any damage to another, like, say, a heavy tank. Say it's a heavy tank. And you can see him at his side. So you shoot him with your machine gun, and this has happened to me before. There will be somebody looking at me with a machine gun that won't do any damage. He shoots me a few times with his machine gun. Then he decides to shoot me with his main cannon, and I explode into a million little pieces. And even though my tank explodes, my turret flies off way into the sky, my tracks are blown off, and the entire vehicle is engulfed in flames, somehow the idiot in broken English is able to say, "Bail out!" Which, seriously, I am thinking about completely changing my launcher language just for the sake of not having to listen to that broken-ass English thing anymore. But the point is it gets me so pissed off when people use their machine gun to ID a target, but then they shoot you anyways instead of actually just paying attention to what their machine gun has done. Okay, that kind of thing really pisses me off. Oh, God, I don't know anymore, okay? I'm going to keep trying. I'm gonna go and try and finish these two tasks. I just have two more, and one of them's the one I'm on now isn't gonna take too long if I don't have to go up against these assholes. But like I said, I will make an update video if I come across another team killer on a Russian server that is Russian, at least as far as I could tell is Russian. And if that happens, then I'm done with the Russian server. I'm completely taking it off the list, and I'll be stuck. I might turn on like the Southeast Asian server or whatever just to check it out again, because I haven't played it since maybe 2014. That's how long it's been. I just have never really played on it much, and that was back before I had my internet upgrade, way back. So it might be a lot more stable and easier to play on now. But I'll give it a go. We'll see. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next Talking War Thunder video.